morning.
Good morning.
What is your full name?
My full name is Sonia Sharma.
Where are you from?
I'm from Patiala.
Can I see your ID?
Yes, here is my passport.
Do you work or are you a student?
I'm a student. I have just recently finished my bachelor's in science.
What was your favorite subject?
My favorite subject was chemistry because it involves organic chemistry as a part, which excites me a lot as it involves a lot of compounds which are used in our daily life.
Okay, let's talk about clothes. Are clothes important to you?
Yes, definitely. Clothes are a necessity to me, and also clothes depicts our personality, and it depends upon our lifestyle about what we are wearing. So yes, definitely clothes are very important.
What kind of clothes do you prefer to wear?
Well, I prefer wearing clothes in which I am very comfortable. Normally, I opt for a jeans and a t-shirt because they are very comfortable and I don't have to worry about anything.
Alright, let's talk about reading. Do you like reading?
Yes, I love reading. I love to read romance fiction. That's my favorite.
Do you prefer reading a book or watching a movie?
Well, I prefer reading a book. As a 200 to 300 pages book can tell us a lot more than a 2.5 hour movie. So definitely I'll love to read a novel or book.
Don't you think what we watch, we remember for a long time?
No, that's up to us. If we like watching movies, we'll remember movies. If we like watching books or reading books, then we'll definitely remember them for a long time.
Let's talk about running. Do you like running and why?
Yes, I like running. I usually go for runnings in the evenings and sometimes in the mornings. Running makes me more fit and energetic. That's why I like to go for a run.
Did you participate in any running races?
Yes, I have participated in running races in my school during sports meet only.
Do you watch athletic games on TV?
Yes, I watch athletic games on TV. Whenever there is Olympics championship going on the TV, I really watch.
What kind of athletic games you like?
I basically like watching swimming and sprinting and even javelin throw.
Why?
Because it involves a lot of strength in all those games and they are very fun to watch as well.
Do you have suitable places for running in your neighborhood?
Yes, I belong to a place where there are a lot of parks and special running places made for the people.
Okay, let's talk about borrowing things. Do you borrow books?
No, I don't like to borrow books from others. Usually I buy them for myself only, and even if I need a book which I can't afford, I usually take it from a library.
What kind of things you borrow from others and why?
Mostly I like to borrow notes regarding the subjects I'm studying. Other than that, I don't usually buy many things from others.
Do you borrow money from your friends?
No, I don't need to borrow money from my friends as I am not financially unstable. My parents support me regarding my financial capabilities, so I don't have to borrow money.
How do you feel when someone borrows something from you?
Basically, I never liked it when someone borrows something from me because I am a very private person and I don't like sharing my things with others.
Would you lend your phone to someone?
No, definitely not, because there are a lot of private things on my phone and even a lot of documents and even my credit and debit cards are saved on my phone, so I won't lend it to anyone.
Alright, now I will give you your 2-minute topic. You will have 1 minute to prepare on that topic. You have to speak for 1 to 2 minutes and I can stop you in between. Fine?
Okay.
Here is your cue card. And this is your paper and pencil.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Okay. Well, basically, I'm a bookworm. I love to read all kinds of books. But here I would like to talk about a particular book which I read last month. I read it on my phone by an ebook app. The name of the book is The Notebook. It is written by a famous novelist, American novelist. His name is Nicholas Sparks. He is famous for all of his works in the romance fiction field, and most of his novels have been made into a movie, and which have, you know, really impressed the audience with its timelines and the facts. Here I would like to talk about this novel which I read. In this novel, there's a boy and a girl who fell in love. It's based on a typical thinking that a girl belongs to a wealthy family while a boy is a laborer. So due to which they got separated. Their story is based on the fact that no matter what we do or what the society barriers them, they still make each other happy, and they get over all the difficulties that came in their life, and they made together till the end. When this book started, there was a man who was reading a novel to an old lady, and after reading 2 to 3 pages, I got to know that the lady had Alzheimer's, and it was in fact based on their own story. The man was telling his own story to his wife, who had forgotten that they were actually in love in their 20s. When the novel started, there was a lot of things which were very interesting. First was the background music. First was the background story actually. It was a scene that the boy came from a war, while the girl was from a very wealthy family, so she wasn't familiar with any kind of difficulties that came in his life. So due to which they got separated, and even their families also played a very important role in separating them. After they were separated, the boy wrote letters for 1 year each day, but the mother of that girl hid it. So the boy, whose name was Noah, went after her even after 10 years of their separation, and when they got to know that what their parents did, they got united. So this is a novel that makes me passionate about love, and it tells me that no matter what form it takes, it still unites at the end. So I'm very pleased with this novel. That's all.
Alright, can I have paper pencil back? Okay, now I will ask you a few questions related to this topic.
Okay.
Would you like to read that novel again?
Yes, definitely. It was like one of the best novels I've ever read. So yeah, sure, I'll read it again.
Why do people read books?
People read books to enhance their knowledge. Some people read it as just a hobby, and some people even just read it to pass their lonely time.
Are younger people interested in the same books as the older one?
Well, it depends upon their preferences and choices. While the older people sometimes like to read religious books, the younger people like to read books that can motivate them. Even they usually read books related to their studies as well, because they have to gain experience from that particular book so that they can exceed in their life.
Do you think e-books will replace print books in the future?
Yes, I think so, because everything is available to us on our mobile phones and computers, that people are, you know, decreasing their methods of reading printed books. Even these days, people usually don't go to libraries at all, because they have access to all these books in their phones only.
Are books telling the story better than movies do?
Yes, definitely. As I have told earlier also, that I'll prefer a 200 to 300 pages book rather than a 2.5 hours movie, because in such a short time, a movie can't cover all the incidents that can take place in that particular book. And also, books connect us to the background stories, and even they form a very special, very creative character analysis for us, so even we feel attached to the characters in the stories.
How can we motivate children to read more?
Well, we can motivate them from their early ages. We can start by giving them books which have animations on them, so that they get more and more interested, and by the time they get older, they will have a connection with the books, and they will think of books as their friends. So they will ultimately have a habit of reading the books.
All right, this is the end of your speaking. Thank you.